Mel's on the MIC.
I love your personality on the radio. It's always upbeat, bubbly, is I don't know what. Like a contagious vibe.
My Kiss 103.1.
Jamming on the JOB with you inside the biggest office party in the CTX. And I got a very special guest on the phone line with me. You can catch this gentleman this weekend as part of the New York Kings of Comedy. Coming to the Laugh It Up Comedy Lounge this weekend in Killeen. Ladies and gentlemen, Rob Stapleton is on the phone line with me.
Yes, sir. Excited, baby. The New York Kings, we've been touring all around the country. We make our way to Killeen, baby. We get ready to bring it. We're going to make everybody laugh till they hurt. You know what I mean?
No doubt. Now, who else is on this tour with you real quick?
Well, this is the thing. The New York Kings, a lot of times, no knock to a lot of shows. You get a couple of features and you get a headliner. One thing you get the New York Kings, you get five headliners on one show. Mm-hmm. You got your boy, me, $8, Rob Stapleton. You got Talent Is Just Comedy. You got the gangster comedy Capone. You got my man Drew Frazier. And then you got my man, the Latin sensation, Mark Vieira, who everyone could check out on the new season of Def Comedy Jam on HBO in the next couple of weeks.
No doubt. That sounds like a big lineup right there. That is a huge lineup.
It's crazy. It's one of the shows. We don't like to oversell it. From the beginning to the end, it is what it is. From the beginning, from the first comic hits the stage, the ceiling was already raised. We pass the baton to the next comic, and they bring that damn energy. You know what I mean? We just keep it running straight across, you know?
Rob Stapleton, once again, New York Kings of Comedy, coming to the Laugh It Up Comedy Lounge this weekend. Let's talk about you, brother. What you been up to lately, my man?
Well, you know, doing on the road with these guys, you know, selling out and doing shows all over. That keeps us busy. And then I'm also doing the post-production of my first feature film. I've been in a few other films, a couple of Rockefeller films and TV work. But I got a huge film coming out called The Stuff that'll come out on 2018 that everyone could really look out for. And we'll talk about that probably the next conversation when I'll be calling into the radio. But make sure everyone looks out for the movie called The Stuff. Michael Blackston, me, Arnaz J. We got a couple of surprises in that one. That's like an action comedy thing, but that's going to make a lot of noise.
No doubt. The Stuff. Y'all be on the lookout for that, man. Now I'm going to ask you the question that I ask all these comics that's been coming through here lately. What's up with the Netflix money? Are we getting Netflix money next year sometime?
Oh, man, that Netflix money is endless. You know what I mean? You know what the thing was? I'm going to tell you why everybody's getting these Netflix deals, because when you release a movie, Your first weekend, you got to make a certain amount.
Right.
If you don't, your movie flops. If you don't do numbers, that's why it's so important. These fire sticks are killing people. You got to take your butt to the movie theater, buy a ticket, sit your butt in the seat, and get the box office revenue up. But when you do a Netflix film, no one really clicks it that way.
Right.
And people pass the word to each other in those movies. It's not just monitored over that first weekend, pretty much.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Right. Nah, I just been talking.
So that's why Chappelle, Chris Rock, everybody. And if you look at Will Smith, got a movie coming on there, like in the next couple of weeks. You know, got Adam Sandler. And that's the way to go now. It's actually bigger than HBO right now.
Right.
You know?
That's why I'm asking every comedian I come in contact with. What's up with the Netflix money?
And Netflix knows it too. I just got an email from them. They raised my price up from $10 to $10.99. You know, they try not to say $11. You know,
we got to pay all y'all comedians. Y'all want this content? We got to pay y'all.
You know what I mean? Well, on the real, I want to give a big shout out to the people at the Laugh It Up Comedy Club, man, because first of all, man, I did the first week, the grand opening that they did. So this will be my second time coming back, but I'm coming back with the tour, which makes it even more special. And these brothers are people from around the way, mm-hmm. bringing great grown-up entertainment locally for the people in the area.
Right.
You know, a lot of times, man, people complain about, man, there's nothing to do.
Exactly.
Nothing to do. And this is a big thing for the guys, because you may be with your lady, and you may not be doing that good. You know what I mean? But right. It's good to go out for a comedy show for 2 hours and laugh together, and then you come home and realize things aren't that bad. You know what I mean? You know,
right.
If you got an envelope with a bill in it, don't open the bill. Go to the show. Come home and still don't open that bill when you get home. You know what I mean? But at least you
we'll get to it later.
Yeah, get to that later. You know what I mean? But seriously, man, I'm really proud of the owners of the club, man. It's good to see people putting money back into the community and the community coming out. And they bringing the best of the best. I mean, Cedric Entertainer, Mike Epps, Michael Blackston, the New York Kings. I mean, they're not just doing people who are trying to make it. They're doing the best of the best of the crop. Right. Coming to hitting those stages each and every week. And it's not like they're doing this once a month or every 3 months. So to be here for the anniversary, we're going to bring the ruckus. That's going to be crazy.
Right. That is right. It is the anniversary of the Laughing Up Comedy Lounge. And again, because that's why we support this business and we support what they're doing. Every effort that they put in, we support it because this is
important. Oh, yeah, 103 be behind it. 103 be behind it real hard.
And,
you know what I mean?
And that's why we support it, because Black-owned is, and we, and they know, my audience knows me. I preach that on this very show, that the only way that we gonna rise as a people is we support our Black businesses and our Black business owners and stop with the complaining, because y'all don't front on the white man like y'all do us, well, us brothers.
That's right. And we just signed a petition. They got Black Friday. Now they got Light Skin Thursdays too. So I'm just letting people know this
stay
is the first annual.
Stay woke out here. These light skins. Stay woke.
There you go. Stay woke, brother. Stay woke.
Rod Stapleton, once again, ladies and gentlemen, he's going to be here this weekend at the Laughing Up Comedy Lounge, where the anniversary is the New York Kings of Comedy. Bringing the NYC to Texas, man. How crazy is that?
That's right. I'm going to tell you, man, I just want to throw one warning out there. We want all the women to retighten their lace fronts and their weaves, because you might laugh them out this weekend. Retighten your lace fronts and your weaves, because we shaking them loose with laughter this weekend, baby.
No doubt. Make sure y'all get y'all tickets now, eventbrite.com. Also on the website at KaleenLaughLounge.com. Rob, I appreciate your time, brother. Looking forward to the show this weekend.
Hey, man, always good to speak to you, brother. Always good to speak to you, and keep doing great things out there, brother. All right? See y'all this weekend.
No doubt. Thank y'all so much. Rob Stapleton, ladies and gentlemen, catch up this weekend. New York Kings of Comedy at the Laughing Up Comedy Lounge, y'all. Come check it out.
Mills on the MIC.
What's up?
Now heard weekdays from noon to 3 on today's R&B and Old School. 103.1 KISS FM.